Shay, I think it's amazing that you've turned what was your dream and something that you thought would be fun to compete in into a real business for yourself. And you raise sponsors and you do all sorts of stuff around cars all of the time. You're always darting here and there. In fact, I can barely keep track of where you are.
Even yeah, me too.
Instagram. Your husband probably has trouble keeping track of where you are sometimes. But what would you say, like, if you were talking to a young woman who has a dream of being competitive in something, what are a couple of things that you think have been critical to your success and things that you think are critical for you going forward to continue or grow your success?
Yeah, no, that's a great like question and point, because I get that occasionally. And I think I get it more often now just because I've been around a little bit longer. And I've had successes, and I certainly have had, you know, failures. If not, I've had more failures than I have had successes. Of course, we talk about those. And it's weird to give advice because I feel like in this industry in particular, you've got to do what's best for you per opportunity, and you have to do what's best for you per when things aren't quite going as according to plan. And I think that though could be, you know, parlayed very well into anything, business, life, relationships, etc. But a couple of things, you know, now looking back, I spent too much time on the computer and not enough on the phone. So an advice to like a young person, and especially women, right? Because women can sometimes have the tendency to like hide behind the computer and not get out and do the networking, but women are some of the best networkers. So that I don't quite, you know, always understand when, and I recall I was that person, you know, but I was also much younger. I was, you know, 17, 18, 19 years old. I didn't know anybody in the industry. I didn't have any immediate mentors up until, you know, like somebody, Lynn St. James, who is a 7-time Indianapolis 500 driver and hugely successful Daytona 500 winner. It wasn't until I had, you know, really kind of looked for some people that I needed to find advice from myself that helped me in achieving the confidence and I've always been comfortable and confident. I mean, don't get me wrong. I've always been able to walk into a room and feel like I can make a friend. And that's just my individual charisma. That was instilled in me in a long time ago. But I did, because I wasn't knowledgeable about my industry as a young person, I did hide behind the computer. So my first bit of advice would be, you know, pick up the phone and start making some real connections, even if it's voice to name, and then continue that voice to name to showing up. So if it's trade shows, for us, it's performance racing industry in Indianapolis, or it's SEMA out in Vegas, making connections and showing up, like making sure that if you want to meet somebody, or if there is a particular partner that you want to partner with, even if it's in the long term, they need to see that you're around constantly, whether you're in a car or you're not in a car. So showing up and taking that action to make the next step and turning that action into really a relationship. You know, I tell actually just this past December, I was at Performance Racing Industry on a women's panel in motorsports, and they asked, you know, how are you successful in your sponsorship? And I said, it's real simple if you can look at it just like this, or think about it just like this. They have to be emotionally invested in you as a person. It has to bring them to tears to say no to you as an individual. And if you can get them to say yes to you as an individual, then you have to sell them on the business plan. And that's really where you have to have your ducks in a row. I always feel like from a business standpoint, I've been very calculated, because I couldn't afford the risk. You know, as somebody with no funding, no personal wealth, no backup plan, I had to have calculated risk in everything that I did. And so I couldn't sacrifice certain things. I couldn't walk away with knowing that I had emotionally gotten somebody to say a yes, but from a business perspective say no. So I worked super hard on the business end. And that's really where then the computer work comes, you know, pitching the proper proposals. And it's thinking outside of the box. You know, it's not just about, you got to know who you're talking to. You got to research the company. You got to know the ins and the outs. You got to know what their dog's name is, for heaven's sake. And you have to think like, it's not what you want. It's what they want. And you have to understand the market that they're in. You have to understand the product or the service or the company. And then the last bit of advice that I would give is, it needs to be something that can easily fit into your lifestyle.